bruv, you are having a bubble.
What is going on, everybody? Welcome to another silver predictions video, and today we are going to be looking at a few Brazil silvers. Before I do get started though, if you want to check out the previous three prediction videos, I'll be in the description below, featuring a few five-star skillers and pacey centre backs that you might want to keep your eye out for on the web app when it comes out soon, hopefully next month. But anyway, keep suggesting players for me to do in these videos. A few five-star skillers will do. Tweet me with players that who you think will be five-star skills and give me video evidence, of course, whether that be YouTube or any other video sharing website, of course, and also drop a like on this video if you do enjoy this series. But we're now going to get started onto the first player of this episode, and it is a familiar face, who is Marco Sewell, and he has gone down to a 74 rated card in head-to-head this year. Remember guys, these stats are taken from their current head-to-head stats, so I'm presuming these stats will be pretty similar in FIFA 14, and he'll be a pretty sick silver. All around decent stats there. Shame he has lost his 5-star skill moves. But, you know, 4-star skills will be great, and you never know, with EA, they could give his 5-star skills back to him, which would be absolutely amazing, because when he had 5-star skills in FIFA 12 and FIFA 11, he was definitely one of my favourite players to use in the game. But, you know, his pace has dropped by quite a lot, I believe. But, you know, nice shooting for a silver, nice passing and nice dribbling. But now we are going to move on to a new player who is dubbed as the new Neymar, and that is Nielton, of course. But yeah, as you can see there, he has 4-star skills. I've seen a couple of videos and seen him play a few times, and he doesn't really warrant 5-star skill moves in my opinion. He might do in the future, you never know, he's only young. But you know, everyone I've asked as well also says he doesn't deserve 5-star skill moves at the moment. You know, he pulls off skills, but not the most advanced skills like Neymar does. But you know, he looks like a pretty good card indeed. I've put him as a low rated silver. He's a 63 bronze rated player in head to head, but I think he'll go up to around a 65 or a 66. So yeah guys, he looks like a pretty decent card, watch out for him. And now Alton, who is of course in this year's ultimate team with his 5-star skills in the Saudi league. But as you can see, his pace has gone up drastically, as well as his dribbling in head to head, which is pretty amazing. If he keeps him stats for FIFA ultimate team 14, he'll be a pretty expensive player with that pace and dribbling. It looks pretty overpowered, to be fair. He's a quite a small guy and a weak guy, but you know, he'll be pretty quick, and the 5-star skills will definitely come in useful when getting past players, of course. Everyone loves 5-star skills in this game because of that overpowered scoop turn. But anyway, Marlos, and you're probably thinking, wait a minute, he's not in this year's ultimate team, and I'm not sure if he'll be in the next, but you know, I thought I'd include him anyway, just in case EA do include the Ukrainian league into FIFA 14. I hope they do, because there'll be some amazing players in ultimate team 14, of course, including Marlos, who used to have 5-star skills back in FIFA 12 and FIFA 11, and what a player he was with 5-star skills and 2-star weak foot. You know, them stats, I think he'll stay pretty much the same, but he'll move out to a right wing or even a left wing, because that's where he plays for his new club in Ukraine. So yeah, EA, if you do watch this video, please try and include the Ukrainian league into FIFA 14, so Marlos and people like Marcio Azevedo can come back into ultimate team, of course. But anyway, moving on to Carlos Alberto, the Brazilian from, as you can see there, he has no club badge on him because he currently doesn't have a club, I believe. I think he's left Vasco, or his contract ran out, and I believe he'll go down to a silver rated card like he was last year in ultimate team. But he'll be a pretty nice card if he does find a team and is in ultimate team. 5-star skills, 4-star weak foot, and decent dribbling on him. And now we're going to move on to another Ukrainian player called Dudu, I believe. But I'm just going to call him Eduardo in this video. But yeah, he's in the Ukrainian league too for Dynamo Kiev. So EA, please try and include that league into FIFA 14. He was 5-star skills in a FIFA 11, so I don't see why he won't be 5-star skills in the new FIFA, of course, recommended by FIFA Raw as well. And also my friend on Twitter, Mike, did help me with these stats, so thank you to him, as he does watch the Ukrainian league and is familiar with Dudu. But yeah, 86 pace, 81 dribbling, 71 passing, and 5-star skills, of course, would be a great player to get hold of. But you know, we are going to have to wait for EA to confirm what leagues are in the next FIFA, of course. But anyway guys, that is the end of the video. I hope you did enjoy this Brasilva episode, and please be sure to drop the video a like, of course. And if you want to suggest any players, go ahead and do so. There's a template in the description below, so if you want to go make your own players and tweet me them, go ahead and do that. Follow me on Twitter at R9Wright. And if you want to see any gold player predictions, go and check out GCII Messi. He's currently doing them. I might do gold players in the future, but right now I'm having fun looking for new silver players, of course. So if you've got any suggestions, go ahead and leave them in the comments, and I will see you for another video soon. Take care, guys.